There's a huge range of options out there in the market for reflashing or retuning the factory ECUs and a lot of the late model GM product. However, at some point when we're starting to look at more advanced packages, maybe for drag specific applications, maybe the addition of turbochargers, superchargers, or multi-stage nitrous, the factory PCM or ECU can become a limiting factor. So we're here to talk to Tom from Holley EFI about their Dominator and HP range of ECUs and some of the advanced functionality. So particularly when we are moving to some of these more sophisticated engine packages, some of the control functionality in the Holley EFI range becomes really critical. Let's start by talking about boost control, which is obviously so critical for turbocharged vehicles. So what do Holley offer there?
So with the boost control options, you utilize the HP ECU, and you can also utilize the Dominator. My general recommendation, anybody that's going to use any type of a power adder going to race car, be go with the Dominator ECU because of its expanded input-output capabilities. We've got a fully functional boost controller that's built into the system that can run single-port and dual-port wastegates with multiple pressure input controls, be it compressor pressure, measured, fixed. We can do boost versus time, boost versus RPM, boost versus speed, and manual boost. We've got boost builder functionality that's tied into the system that we can program fixed fuel, fixed time, and even nitrous activation in with the system. And then beyond the basic boost control, you can get into our advanced ICF tables, which allows you to do 8 1-axis tables, 8 2-axis, 8 1-axis per gear, and 8 2-axis per gear tables to control a lot of things, including boost modulation and offsets that you can base off of any axis that you want to utilize, including any custom input. So it gives you a real broad spectrum boost control that really has a lot of capabilities. Combined, it really doesn't exist with many systems on the market today.
Okay, obviously a very complete system there. Just so our viewers can get a little bit of an idea of maybe how some of those additional tables could be used, could you give us an example of a typical application there maybe?
As far as using the advanced tables, you can have your basic boost controls. Maybe you're doing boost versus time, you're doing boost versus speed. When you get into the advanced tables, it allows you to do some offset. So we've got some boost scramble features that are built into it where you can just simply hit a button and increase or decrease. But you can get into the multiple tables, it actually potentially even allow you to put in a variable knob where you can adjust, maybe get up there and the track's a little bit greasy, something's going on, you want to increase or decrease the amount of boost. You may be able to do something based on slew rates between front and rear wheel speed, basically for slip and other things, to do boost offsets modulation, even speed the car up or slow the car down as a general example.
So essentially there, it sounds like the flexibility with the system, you could basically do just about anything you want based on what you're trying to achieve, how much traction you've got, and how smart you want to be with those additional tables?
Correct. I always tell people you make the Holley system as simple, as complex as you want. With the advanced tables that we give you and the custom input-output logic, the folks that can think outside the box can really utilize it. Within reason, if you can think it with the Holley system, you can pretty much control it.
I think that's so important, and particularly for those customers who are making a lot of power and are into drag racing, obviously maximizing optimizing the power delivery to the amount of traction on the track is really the key to getting down the track with a fast ET or quick ET. And the other thing, we see the popularity now of these no prep events where traction is really limited. So trying to get that boost control dialed in is so critical. Now, just let's talk about maybe the case where you didn't quite have it right and the car does end up with wheel spin. With the traction control through the Holley EFI system, what flexibility have we got there to control that wheel spin and bring the car back and get grip again?
So there's a lot of things you can do. There's a lot of ways that you can manage torque outside of traction control. If you're going to use our traction control ICF, we actually partnered with Shannon Davis at David's Traction Technologies, and we have capability of working in conjunction with his TC1 and TC2 boxes designed for Holley EFI and his profiler. So we'll utilize your track control with inputs into the Holley system. At that point, you'll be able to utilize the TC1 TC2 to offset timing, drive-by-wire throttle reduction with drive-by-wire controls, nitrous offsets, boost offsets, as well as your restore rates through the system.
So just for those who aren't familiar, that profiler system where we're looking there at matching essentially the wheel speed versus time to what could be considered an ideal run. So if the wheel speed ends up exceeding that profile that you've set, that indicates to the ECU that the car is in wheel spin?
Correct. And it'll allow it to manage torque by doing power reduction.
Now, also, you've mentioned nitrous there. Can you tell us about the nitrous control functionality? Obviously, when it comes to nitrous, we've got options of wet systems where both the nitrous and additional fuel is injected through the nitrous nozzle. There's also options of a dry system where the ECU then has to do some of the hard work of injecting additional fuel as well as controlling the timing. What options have we got there with the Holley system?
So the HP system, you can program up to 4 stages of wet or dry progressive nitrous, but again, you are limited to 4 inputs and 4 outputs. When you get into the Dominator systems, and again, one of the reasons I recommend a Dominator with a power adder, because you have the additional inputs and outputs, the Holley system actually allows the end user to control up to 8 stages of wet or dry progressive nitrous controls.
So with the dry system, then the ECU will have, I'm guessing, adjustable tables for the additional fuel supply as well when those stages are active?
Correct. So you'll have a multi-axis table on your nitrous versus your fuel enrichment that you'll be able to do. I really recommend, if you're utilizing the Holley EFI, to go with the dry system. It's cleaner, it reduces complexity. And a lot of times you may have somebody that's going from carburetor EFI that has an existing single stage kit, maybe they want to go dual stage. One of the things a lot of people don't think about is there's no reason why you can't take your fuel side, change your solenoids that you're jetting, and actually take that single stage nozzle or a single stage plate and simply do a two-stage system with it.
Yeah, that makes a lot of sense, really, if you've got that sort of system and want to get a little bit more power out of it. Okay, so now moving on beyond that as well, a lot of the cars we're seeing now, they're making more and more power, and that obviously requires additional fuel. And we're getting to a point where supplying enough fuel for some of these really high horsepower cars, you know, 1,500, 2,000 horsepower, that's going to become problematic with a single injector. The injector's going to have to be so big that you won't be able to make the car idle. It won't be able to cruise and achieve good air fuel ratios. So how can we deal with that with the Holley system?
The Dominator system actually has the ability to run up to 24 fuel injectors. So you can run 3 injector sets as well as staging and programmability. We're going to have some additional features with that that add some more, I don't necessarily complexity, but flexibility. Guys are utilizing multiple injector sets coming out here in the first part of 2018, hopefully.
Now, on top of that, once the car's actually gone down the strip, and I'm just going to use drag racing for an example here, but I mean any high-powered car, we really want to know what actually has gone on while we've been driving the car. So what have we got in the way of options for analyzing the data from a run?
So the HP and the Dominator system both have internal data logging capabilities. You can program the data logging up to 100 samples, so up to 100 hertz. One of the things that's nice about the Holley system compared to a lot of other systems in the market is the Holley system actually data logs everything. Every factory input or output, as well as any custom input or output you create. But then you can go in and you can customize the view. You can select what data you want to look at. You can adjust filtering, min-max rate, scaling. You can split panes and panels up. We give you the ability to do active overlays on your run, as well as doing comparison views of one log to another.
It sounds like it's definitely a very complete system, and you've got all of those options in there for the guys from standard everyday street cars through to ones running a lot of nitrous, a lot of boost, and wanting to get the most out of their car on the drag strip. If people want to find out more about the system, how can they reach out?
They can find a lot of information by going to our website. They can simply visit us at holley.com.
That's great. Thanks for your time there, Tom.
Thank you.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson. You'll learn about performance engine building and EFI tuning, and you'll also have the chance to ask questions, which I'll be answering live. Remember, it's 100% free, so follow the link to claim your spot.